at that very moment you put it on.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's a process.
Oh, wow.
Man. Could be instant, but it may not be.
Yeah, he's weakened it. He's melted away. He's gone. So let's go on here. Let's see here. And we talked some scriptures. Apostle Paul says, and look at 1 Corinthians 4:12. As I check the time, 1 Corinthians 4:12. Somebody read that for us, if you will. Okay, we're doing good.
1 Corinthians 4:12.
Mm-hmm. That's tough, yeah.
And labor, working with our own hands,
mm-hmm.
being reviled, we bless. Being persecuted, we suffer it.
Mm. Being defamed, we put up with it. We are made as the filth of the world and the offscouring of all things until this day. So, and then you jump back up to verse 10, it says, we're fools for Christ's sake. We're fools for Christ's sake. Okay, and then Paul, again in Romans 12 and 20. Anybody getting anything yet out of this? Okay, this is your covenant, New Testament believers. This is what the Apostle Paul had to learn, to love like Jesus learned. And then once he learned that, here's what he said. 1 Corinthians 12:20. What did he say? Look, read verse 19 if it is. Read verse 18 if you will.
If it be possible, as much as lies in you, live peacefully with all men.
Mm-hmm.
Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine. I will repay, saith the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, if thine enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirst, give him drink. For in so doing, thou shalt heap coals of fire on his head.
Mm. Woo! That's verse, Romans 12, verse 20 is our last
one. First Corinthians.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. And verse 21 says, be not overcome, what? Of evil. But overcome evil. How do you do it?
With good.
You got somebody giving you a hard time? You can't, don't go an eye for an eye. That's just average. You're just mediocre. But if you got somebody that's trying to tear you down, kill you, mess you up, he says, do what? Do good. Overcome some evil with good. Overcome evil with good. He says, well, if you do that, you heap a coal of fire. You just burn them up. You just zap. Ooh, now you got to want to do it.
Yeah.
You got to want to do it. If you don't do it, then you are defeating yourself. You're helping the enemy to defeat you. Oh, boy. This ain't got time to tell you if you don't do it. If Jesus decided to take revenge, like, hold up on this cross thing. Get me down off of here. He just went to kicking everybody around and winning like he did in that temple.
Mm.
What would you and I be today?
Lost.
Lost. Because he didn't die on the cross. He lost his cool. He didn't stay on the cross. It was a plan for you to stay on the cross and die, Jesus, so that you can go to hell and pay the price for everybody. Well, I got mad. They spit on me. Talked about my mama. She was right down there. Everybody heard it. I'm coming down. I'll hold up.
Hey, Brother Donnell.
Yes, sir.
Love. That's what we're speaking of, right?
That's right.
I don't want someone to go in and mess their money up and they're going to get put out their place. Should we help them?
Man, they don't want you to help them, but they cause the problem to themselves.
Yeah.
You pray about me and see what God will have you to do.
even if they got children.
No matter what, love don't measure the circumstances. Love measure what can I do? What do I make? What do I make a positive difference?
Well, let me understand this. We mess up and God still take care of us.
Yeah. Can you find that scripture? Love covers what?
Multitudes.
Right, so that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, so love, it is a bad act, it ain't worth nothing. Why should I help him? Well, yeah, Jesus saved, the Lord said about us. Which one of them has got it all going on perfect and all that? And God says I need to respond to them. God doesn't respond to us because of what we've done or deserve. He responds to us because he loves us.
Exactly.
So it's all about love. That neighbor next door might be a bad act, getting drunk all the time, messing up all the time. But the rain and the sun is still what? Coming down for him.
But still, I'm saying, so the person helped that person.
Sure.
But let's qualify that. Sometimes helping a person is not always giving, Brother Curtis.
Right.
Sometimes it's helping them. Sometimes it is giving. But sometimes it's helping them so that they won't get into that situation again.
Mm-hmm.
So it can be twofold, mm-hmm. or it could be multifold.
Mm-hmm.
It is not just mm-hmm. our singular.
I understand that, but I would just say in this particular moment,
mm-hmm.
they would mess their money up. And they getting put out.
Yeah.
And they have children. So should we just overlook that? Or talking ain't gonna help. Talking ain't gonna help. They want their money or you gotta get out.
Well, you know, prayer and, you know, getting, and I'm going to show you here in the next scripture here, getting the means to help them through love has to come from a divine intervention.
Right.
I need God to tell me what to do, how to do it, so that I can make a difference.
Right.
So it could be all kind of ways.
Yeah, all kind of ways. If you say they're going to be evicted if they're saying,
mm-hmm.
well, instead of, if that person has blown the money,
mm-hmm.
you don't give it to them.
Mm-hmm.
If it's their
rent
money,
right.
you go and pay the rent.
Exactly. Yeah,
right,
I know that. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Give it to them.
I know that. Yeah, I know that.
Yeah.
Not give it to the person, but go
right.
give it to the person.
Sure. Sure.
Exactly.
There's all kind of ways that you can help out and demonstrate
exactly.
the love without it, because Jesus, don't throw your pearl over to the pig.
First Peter 4:8 is where you told me to find.
What is that, Candy?
The cover of multitude of sins.
What scripture was it?
First Peter 4:8.
That's why Sister Hill needs to preach on this next week.
Okay.
We can't get to all these scriptures. First Peter 4:8. Okay, what does it do? Read it there.
And above all things, have fervent charity among yourselves.
So
charity shall cover the multitude of sins.
And charity is just love in action. Have some real effective love among yourselves, because charity will cover a whole bunch of what? Sins. We got to understand, folks, when people we deal with down here on the earth, most of them ain't going to be saved. Most of them don't know nothing about your God or how you love Jesus and what the Bible says. And most of them don't know that. The only way they're going to get a glimpse of the nature of God is through who? You. Mm-hmm. Yeah, God loved you while you was a sinner, didn't know him, hated him, was an enemy of his. He loved you and he showed his love. They don't know that. So how do they get to know that? Coming through us. Okay, look at the scripture. Verse 46 of our lesson. For if you love them which do what? Love you. That's Matthew 5:46. If you love them which love you, what reward have you? That's me and my family, and 3 or 4 or 5 of us, and that's it.
That's
you know, that's it. You mess with one of us, all 3 of us, 8, 9, 10, 11 of us coming after you. I love everybody. Take care of all of them. Love thy people.
Mm-hmm.
What's your reward? He says, big deal. And the publicans, he says, they do the same. Publicans or some crooked officials.
Republicans.
Yeah, the Republicans.
You know, there's some people that don't like that. There's some people that don't like that. Can't stand a Republican. Can't stand the Republican. Can't stand them Democrats. Can't stand them or Libertarians. Can't stand them Confederates down there. Can't stand them. Oh, walk into a building that's got this Confederate flag on. Oh, you just messed up with me, man. Man, you put that away. We're going to see. How you going to do business with somebody like that?
Ouch.
How you going to do that? Guy got a Confederate flag on his truck with a rifle in the window. How we going to be
and
free?
And a noose. Yeah.
Not to forget the noose. That's under the truck. Or under the floor bed. How we going to do business? How we going to do this? Hmm. You can't love them. Oh, Jesus says, well, the Confederates love the Confederates, Democrats love the Democrats, Republicans, Libertarians, everybody getting along. No. He says, well, I just love people that are just like me. I know we're going to get along. Jesus says, what's your reward? What have you proven? You're just average. It's like that across the board. You got to rise above that. Remember last week he says, unless your righteousness exceed their righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, you have no reward in heaven. Ain't no way you get here. So you got to go above that. Don't be average. Don't be mediocre. So how? Show me the means. Here's the means. Here's how you do it. Here's how you keep it in you. 2 Peter 1 and 4. Okay, might want to read verse 3 of that. 2 Peter, the first chapter, verse 3.
According as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain, all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
Okay, so here it is in the middle of verse 4, that by these, when you know what you have received from Christ, you take inventory of what have I received from Jesus Christ, I know that I am a partaker, I share in his nature. It's not a natural nature, it's a divine nature. A divine nature, I escape the ways of the world, and I'm now living on a higher order, which matches the nature that God has, because God gave me that divine nature. And once you realize that you got that divine nature, yeah, you can love past hate. You can bless those. You can actually demonstrate. You can actually do it. Make a cake. Make a dress. Something for that old crazy neighbor over there. Do something, an act of love. And it says you escape. You escape it. So you have to realize that you got his divine nature. And that's, and so verse 47 of our lesson says, if you salute your brother only, verse 47, if you high and appreciate and give honor and respect to them only, what do ye more than others? You're not doing no more than anybody else. So, and that's what they do. He says, don't they already do that all the time? Republicans can sit down with a Republican, a Democrat with a Democratic convention, and all like this, and they don't do business. Brother Curtis, do you do commercial business with the commercial world? I guarantee you most of them guys are what? Republicans. Because they have a political interest that identifies them. The cheapest labor I can get, the less rules on my business, the more I like it. Yeah. That's them, you know. The less I can do what I can do without nobody getting in my way, the more I like it. Well, we all like it like that, so we're all Republicans, Democrats. Just to hear what they say. Okay. You know, that's how they, you know. So everybody got their own philosophies, own ways of thinking, and I can get along with them because we think alike. How many have been got friends like that and heard people say that? I can get along with them because we think alike. we can travel together to the convention together, or we're out of town driving the same car, because we're going to think and talk alike. I'm not going to have any opposition the way I feel or think. Personally, I prefer to be with the opposite-minded person, because I can find out where they are, what they're thinking. Some of my best business partners are Republicans. Not saying I'm a Democrat, but some of my best partners are Republicans. Because I want to know what you're thinking.
They don't mind telling you.
They don't mind telling you.
I
deliberately go out to South Tulsa every morning with a cup of coffee and sit in the coffee shops. Only spot in the room. Guess what I'm hearing?
But so you're ascribed to the principle that stay close to your friend and close to your enemy.
Yeah. That's right. I wonder what they're thinking. Why do they hate Obama? Why don't they like health care for everyone?
I don't know.
You got against that?
If you ask me, I can give you a whole page.
Okay, but I want to hear from them, you know. Why don't you invite me to your country club?
Them.
I mean, how come I can't be a member of your country club? What is it that you hate about? See, I drink coffee like you do. What is it that you don't like about? Now you say, man, you shouldn't go over there and cross the line, get in the enemy's territory. Jesus says, what have you accomplished if you don't?
Brother Williams, I'd like to make an observation here, please. All right, we were in, Sister Candy just read in 2 Peter.
Mm-hmm.
I think, and we don't have time to do it,
mm-hmm.
but to address Brother Curtis's concerns mm-hmm. that he asked earlier,
mm-hmm.
you know, really, how do you do this? How do you love?
Mm-hmm.
The how-tos.
Mm-hmm.
We need to go on down through chapter 10.
Verse 10.
Verse 10,
Sorry.
Verse 10 says,
of 2 Peter.
2 Peter 1.
Uh-huh.
And we don't have time to do it now.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
the 10th verse says, wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence mm-hmm. to make your calling and election sure.
Yeah.
For if you do these things,
mm-hmm.
you shall never fall.
Never fall.
So the converse is true. If you don't do those things, you're going to fall.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And from where Sister Candace started reading up until that verse, it tells you what things you have to do.
It's about six or seven steps right there. What you do.
How you do.
But
it.
You know, I'm going to have to say this.
Right.
I'm going to have to say this, what you just got through saying too, Brother Donnell. Can't none of them do none of it if you ain't getting on your knees and praying and ask God give it to you.
No.
That's right.
That's the bottom line.
Yeah, that's right.
Give to you the wherewithal, the how to do it. But then what he has already given to us, and we don't realize.
Is his divine nature.
I got his nature. I can do it.
Yes, you can do it. But at the same time, if you can't do it, you better give your knees and ask God to give it to you.
Hello, God, remind me of who I am. Remind me that when I got saved and confessed you as Savior, you gave me that divine nature of yours. And if you can love your enemies, then surely I can love this little peak squeak down here on the floor.
Here's where, when you talk about prayer, none of it will work. Okay, he's imparted to us, his divine nature. But look at verse 5. It says, and besides this,
mm-hmm.
that's where that part comes in when you're talking about it. Mm-hmm. You got to give diligence to it.
Yeah.
We can't just say we've got his
divine nature
and just
and
go
show
on
up
and do
for
what we want. Right. But we've got to give diligence to it. That's where that prayer comes in that you're talking about.
You just say, I got it.
Because if I go and put a key to your car, mm-hmm. you're going to say, Brother Kirk, that's okay.
Yeah.
Talk to me.
No, that's not all right.
Yeah.
I know you have a job,
and
it's going to cost about $500 to get this done. And I want you to get my
job. But at the same time,
and I'm
not coming to church.
Well,
I come to church next Sunday. Will you look at me straight?
I'm not going to look at you straight.
What we're talking about. If we can say it's easy, but it's not easy.
No, that's why
I'm telling you right now. We can say it's easy, but it's not easy.
No, it's not easy.
I deal with people every day.
It's not easy.
And I deal with people who I did what? Well, I said, Lord, why are you giving these type of people?
Here's how you make it easy. Is that, like she said, those steps. You got to give diligence to looking what the word says.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm trying to do.
What I do, what I do. You got
to do that. I'm trying to do that. Yeah.
As soon as you get away from the how-to steps,
yeah,
exactly. You're going to be the
death.
Right there,
exactly.
You go.
Exactly. Yeah. We can't just get up in the morning and say, I love you.
Yeah, and then, no. It's not automatic.
It's not like that.
You have it in you, but more than likely, you're not going to reach down there and get it.
Until it's penetrated to you.
That's right.
Once it's penetrated to you.
Until you read some words, get into some prayer, and all that kind of. Then you say, you know what, I got it.
Yeah, exactly.
What's a $500 car scratch on a $1,000s?
Just like she said.
Compared to what? Eternity.
Just like she said, love. You don't get love overnight, and you got to build up to it. This same thing right here, this is process.
But she can make you feel real bad by what you that you said that you did.
Right.
You know, like a scratch the feet. And what she can do is say, okay, Brother Curtis, when's the last time you had your oil change in your car? Oh, oil change? Look at those tires, man. You need some new tires. And all of a sudden, she sent a check to your house for some new tires at down in Hilton. You say, where'd that come from? Sister Hill. Wow, and I scratched your car. You know what that's going to do? Melt you like we had fire.
That's a different thing right
there. That's how she overcome you.
Yeah, exactly.
That's how she overcome you. You know what you do? You run over there. Sister Hill, here, look at that paint. That's how you do it. In action. That's how she responds back to you in action.
Yeah.
You say, I can't go buy Curtis no tires. I didn't scratch my car. Well, all right. I thought you a child of God. You can do that if you want to.
All right, brother. Love it,
that's right.
Thank you.